The Internet Archive. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I want to share with you today a website that I use frequently, and in fact, quite literally, yesterday as I was working on an article, I used it to recover an old version of an article that I'd actually lost from my website. I'll show you what I mean and what it's all about. Let's go over here to Windows 10, and I'm going to go to archive.org. Now, the Internet Archive has buckets of things on it. It really does. And you could spend a lot of time just browsing the information that's available here. There is just so much, be it archived copies of websites, movies, audios, videos, I mean, just all sorts of stuff. But one of the ways that it turns out to be incredibly useful, either as almost a backup tool and as a really interesting research tool, is the Wayback Machine, what they call the Wayback Machine. So I'm going to enter in a URL here, askleo.com. And the Wayback Machine is showing me now how often over the last number of years it has been taking copies, archiving copies of that URL. Now, unfortunately, it's not the entire site. You actually have to do this page by page if you want the entire site to be, or if you want to fetch the entire site. But the bottom line is that over time, the Wayback Machine, archive.org, will in fact spider and capture pretty much the whole site. So you can see here, it's currently the middle of 2022, and the most recent copy looks like it was taken on the 14th, which is 2 days ago. I have a busy site, it changes often. So Wayback Machine, archive.org, knows to come by periodically and check for updates and copy any of those updates. But you'll notice that it has a bunch of these other dates highlighted here. These are additional dates that it has also archived. So I'm just going to randomly go back to 2016 and say maybe March the 2nd, of which there are two snapshots. I'll take the later one. Archive.org can take a moment to go fetch the data from its deep, deep archives. And sure enough, there comes the page as it was in 2016. You can see back then that it had a slightly different look on the homepage and that there were different questions, the different logo was slightly different. You get the idea. So there's more to AskLeo than AskLeo.com. AskLeo.com, as you can see, it's only got some snapshots, really meaty snapshots, back in 2016. I used to have it on a different URL. It used to be ask-leo.com. If I take a look at that site in the Wayback Machine, I get even more interesting data. Here we go back now to older dates, 36 captures for that particular page, and you can see that was a very different looking site. I have, in fact, used this technology, archive.org, to go back and find the very first AskLeo page that was archived. So I actually have a redirect for this one, and you'll find that it's in the article on which this video is based. But if I go to go.askleo.com/originalAskLeo, that redirects to archive.org and will show you what AskLeo looked like back in 2003. This is August the 14th of 2003. And you can see that I'm talking here about what it was. Originally, it was a for-pay issue. I had an older picture of myself, just a whole bunch of very interesting things. The bottom line here, though, is that archive.org is an incredibly vast resource of things you can use to not only recover web pages that you may have lost, but also recover sites that may have fallen off the internet. For example, many years ago, I used to refer very frequently to a website called Black Viper. It's no longer maintained, but at the time, Black Viper kept very extensive articles on exactly how you should configure your Windows services, something that was a deep black hole mystery to most all of us, actually. And he did a very good job of outlining what the services did, what their interdependencies were, and so on. One day, his site disappeared. It just went offline. I forget the exact reason, but the fact is, for about 2 years, the site was nowhere to be found, except at archive.org. And in fact, one of the things I did was change my references to his site to point to the archive.org cached copy of his site instead. That allowed that information to continue to be used even though his site had disappeared. Yes, there's a lot there. It can be a time sink. It really can, but it's a fun time sink. I strongly encourage you actually to go and spelunk in archive.org and see what kinds of things are interesting to you there. You'll find that there is a tremendous amount of information. Now, the one thing I do have to point out here is that, unfortunately, as an archive, archive.org occasionally runs into issues with politics. In other words, they may archive things that some political or governmental group anywhere in the world that might wish weren't available online in any form. That's government censorship, and for whatever reason, it does exist, right or wrong. What archive.org has done, and I find this very reassuring, is they have multiple data centers in multiple different countries, so that even if one country a data center happens to be located in gives them restrictions on what they can or cannot keep or can or cannot provide to the public, the other data centers can still keep it. That information remains available one way or another. It's a tough line to follow. It's definitely one of those things that keeps lawyers busy. But I think it's an important way of not just keeping the information available in real time, but as a library, keeping this information available in archival form so that in years to come, we can continue to understand exactly what our world looked like today. I hope that was helpful. I hope you find archive.org interesting. For the article on which this video was based, for updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/2484. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.